So here we will see the few more articles of the origin of quantum mechanics. Let me share the screen first and then we will go for the today's lecture. As you know, so far we have completed three different sections of the origin of the quantum mechanics. Here today we are going to consider few more articles. Here I will try to cover the Wien's law, Rayleigh-Jeans law, Einstein's equation, that is the quantum theory of the photoelectric effect, and at the end I will conclude the lecture with the summary of the today's lecture. Now black body radiation and Wien's law. Now up till now I think you are very much familiar with the black body. I have already defined that black body is nothing but it is a body which absorbs entire amount of radiation which incident on it, and it does not reflect any light. Therefore, it appears black. Why it is appearing black? Because this body is capable of absorbing all amount of heat which is incident on it, isn't it? And in the laboratory, if you want to see the black body, so black body is nothing but it is a cavity with the polished wall. क्या है एक spherical color की एक body है जिसके अंदर के वॉल जो है तो कोटेड है ब्लैक बॉडी मटेरियल से और उसको एक छोटी सी कैविटी है, एक होल है, इजंट इट? तो इन द लैबोरेटरी वन कुड एप्रोक्सीमेट द ब्लैक बॉडी बाय ए कैविटी विद ए हाईली पॉलिश्ड वॉल, दिस वन, एंड इफ द वॉल्स ऑफ द कैविटी हैज द स्मॉल होल देन थ्रू दिस होल द लाइट रेडिएशन एंटर इनसाइड द कैविटी व्हेन द इंसिडेंट इनसाइड द पॉलिश्ड वॉल्स दे गेट एब्सॉर्ब एंड आफ्टर द मल्टीपल एब्सॉर्प्शन एंड रिफ्लेक्शन entire quantity of heat which is incident on this black body it get absorbed, and that's why this is called as the black body, isn't it? So if the walls of the cavity has the small holes, then any radiation which enters in the cavity through this hole that get absorbed and it get trapped into the cavity. Another important property of the black body, as we are familiar, that this black body when it is heated at a particular temperature it emits the radiation. That means black body can absorb the entire amount of heat, and at a particular temperature this black body emits the radiation, and these radiations which are emitted by the black body are called as the black body radiations. Now these radiations which are emitted by the black body, these are having frequency, these radiations has the wavelength, these radiations has the velocity, this radiation form the spectrum. All these things we have seen in our previous lectures so far, isn't it? And that's why a black body can also be treated as a perfectly emitter of the radiation. Yani ke black body absorb to karti hai, lekin sath mein black body can emit the radiation, and these radiations which are emitted by this black body, they are called as the black body radiations. And these black body radiations has the capability to form the spectrum. उनका स्पेक्ट्रम फॉर्म होता, हमने देखा था कि हाउ द स्पेक्ट्रम वाज फॉर्मड बाय द ब्लैक बॉडी, इट स्टार्ट्स इंक्रीजिंग विद द वेवलेंथ, इंक्रीजेस टू मैक्सिमम एंड देन स्टार्ट डिक्रीजिंग एट ए पर्टिकुलर वेवलेंथ एंड सो ऑन दिस थिंग. दैट मीन इट कैन बी इमिट ऑल वेवलेंथ्स. दैट मीन द रेडिएशंस व्हिच आर इमिटेड बाय द ब्लैक बॉडी दे हैव द ऑल टाइप ऑफ वेवलेंथ्स. हाउएवर द रेडिएशंस ऑफ द ब्लैक बॉडी इज ऑब्जर्व्ड, इट हैज द टू फॉलोइंग लॉज. दैट मीन्स दिस ब्लैक बॉडी which emits the radiation at a particular temperature, it follows the two important laws. Which are these laws? First one we have seen, that is Stefan's law. What we have seen in the Stefan's law, that thus radiations which are emitted by this black body, that means the black body radiation has the intensity, and this intensity of the emitted radiation at a particular wavelength is directly proportional to the fourth power of the temperature of the black body. That means just we have seen that black body, it is capable of emitting radiation at a particular wavelength, that is the wavelength of the that at a particular temperature. Now this temperature at which the black body starts emitting radiation, at that particular temperature if the body is emitting the radiation, then the wavelength of this emitted radiation is directly proportional to the fourth power of temperature. Whatever the temperature we have seen in the last period, alag alag temperature pe radiation emit hote, to wo that temperature ke upar jo radiation emit ho rahe uski wavelength isko proportional hai to the fourth power of temperature. And this law that the intensity, suppose I directly proportional to T raised to 4, this is nothing but this is called as Stefan fourth power's law, and in short you may call it Stefan's law. How it can be stated? Stefan law state that the black body radiations emitted from the black body at a particular temperature are direct, has the wavelength which is directly proportional to the fourth power of the temperature. Intensity of the emitted radiation for a given wavelength is directly proportional to the fourth power of the temperature of the black body. This statement is nothing but it is called as Stefan fourth power's law. Stefan fourth power's law kiske taluk se hai? Anybody please unmute and tell me. Kiske bare mein discussion chal raha? Please unmute anybody of you and tell me. Kiske taluk se baat chal rahi? Kiske radiations please?
ब्लैक बॉडी
रेडिएशन की इंटेंसिटी उसके टेम्परेचर के फोर्थ पावर से प्रोपोर्शनल रहेगी. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द स्टीफंस लॉ. नाउ वन मोर लॉ इज आल्सो एसोसिएटेड विद द इमिटेड रेडिएशन. कौन से इमिटेड रेडिएशन? रेडिएशन विच आर इमिटेड बाय द ब्लैक बॉडी, टू विच नाउ हियर आफ्टर वी विल कॉल एज ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन. अब हम इनको इसके बाद क्या नाम से पुकारेंगे? ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन. Now these black body radiations also follow the another law. That law it is called as the Wien's law. What is the Wien's law? Let us see here. For a given temperature, we know that at a particular temperature, black body emits the radiation, isn't it? Now the spectrum of this radiation it is formed just we have seen. Therefore, in the spectrum of the emitted radiation has the maximum intensity. For a wavelength lambda maximum is inversely proportional to the temperature of the black body. In the last our lecture we have seen the spectrum. Kaisa tha spectrum? That as the wavelength increases, the intensity also increases, reaches to maximum and then start decreasing. Jo maximum aaya tha usko hum kya bolte the? The maximum intensity of emitted radiation that was observed at a particular wavelength, that wavelength we are calling as a maximum wavelength at which the maximum intensity is observed. And in the symbol we have defined it as a lambda max, isn't it? So what about the Wien's law? Kya keh raha hai Wien's law? Wien's law ye keh raha hai ki at a given temperature the spectrum of the emitted radiation has the maximum intensity, yani peak ka milega for a wavelength lambda maximum is inversely proportional to the black body temperature of the black body. That means as the temperature of the black body is increases, lambda max is goes on decreasing. We have seen this thing even in the our last period also, when the temperature was 440 kV, lambda maximum was 500 nanometer, and as the temperature was increased as the 690 or 1280 and so on, the lambda max was goes on decreasing. यानी कि 550 नैनोमीटर से उतर के 4.5 नैनोमीटर और बाद में इधर उधर बढ़ते हैं. जैसे जैसे टेम्परेचर बढ़ता लैम्ब्डा मैक्स जो है तो कम कम होते जाता. दैट वी हैव आल्सो सीन इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स आल्सो. तो दैट दिस ऑब्जर्वेशन दैट द मैक्सिमम वेवलेंथ एट विच द मैक्सिमम इंटेंसिटी इज ऑब्जर्व इट इज गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग एज द टेम्परेचर गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग. दैट मीन्स वट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द ब्लैक बॉडी एंड द maximum intensity, it is the inverse relation, and this was observed in the spectrum of the black body. Spectrum bole to kya graph? Kiska graph? Kiska graph? Please tell me by unmuting. Kiska graph utare the humne? Please anybody of unmute and tell me what was the spectrum? Spectrum is a graph. Kiska graph? Please tell me. Unmute yourself and tell me. Kiska graph tha wo?
इंटेंसिटी और स्पेक्ट्रम लाइट.
यस, इंटेंसिटी वर्सेस वेवलेंथ का ग्राफ था, और ये ग्राफ एक पर्टिकुलर था कि जैसे जैसे वेवलेंथ बढ़ती इंटेंसिटी तेजी से बढ़ती मैक्सिमम होती, और उसके बाद वेवलेंथ बढ़ी भी तो इंटेंसिटी कम कम होती और डायरेक्ट जो है तो कम कम होती चली जाती. तो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द स्पेक्ट्रम. एंड इफ यू ऑब्जर्व दैट स्पेक्ट्रम फॉर द रिमिटेड रेडिएशन और द ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन एट ए पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर, इट इज फाउंड दैट एज द टेम्परेचर गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग दैट मैक्सिमम इंटेंसिटी ऑफ दैट एट ए पर्टिकुलर वेवलेंथ लैम्ब्डा मैक्स इज गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग एंड दस द रिलेटिव कोल्डर बॉडीज अपीयर्स रेड. अब इसका मतलब क्या होगा? जैसे जैसे अब इसके दोनों के दरमियान टेम्परेचर के दरमियान कैसा रिलेशन है, टेम्परेचर के दरमियान जब इनवर्स रिलेशन है, तो फ्रॉम दिस वन इट इज क्लियर दैट द कोल्डर बॉडीज अपीयर्स रेड as their maximum intensity is in the red end of the spectrum. Red end samajhta na, spectrum it is consisting of from violet to red. Ye hamare spectrum ka region hai with Jouar series. Violet is toward the left hand side and our red color is toward the right hand side. Ye range mein jo hai to relative colder bodies appear as their maximum intensity in the red end of the spectrum, and while hotter bodies appears bluish because of this. When we heat the metal wire, it fires become red hot, and then as the temperature increases, it become the white hot. Isn't it? In classical mechanics also, or in the classical physics also, radiation is considered as the wave, and the calculation of the radiant energy emitted by the black body is carried out as in the two step. First step is that if we consider the black body to be in the shape of cubical metal cavity, as I have shown in the figure. That cavity is there, एक sphere को एक छोटा सा cube है, cube की side की length suppose it is capital L with a small hole at the center. Through this hole, radiations are entering inside the cavity. Any radiation which falls on the hole is lost inside the cavity. The radiation emerges out from the hole also has the characteristics of radiation that has trapped in the cavity. The waves inside the cavity, अब अंदर क्या तैयार हो रहे waves तैयार, radiations किसकी शक्ल में है, waves की शक्ल में है. The waves inside the cavity they form the standing pattern. जो waves तैयार हो रहे radiations के cavity के अंदर वो कैसे हैं? They are in form of standing waves. समझ में आता है? जो रस्सी के ऊपर rope के ऊपर जो waves तैयार होते हैं उस type में जो rope तैयार हो. क्या खास बात है दीदी? वो rope की standing wave किसको बोलेंगे हम? जिसमें एक maxima, minima रहेगा. Wave रहती है ना मोज, maxima, crest, trough. Are you getting please? Anybody unmute? Or all of you please unmute and tell me. Do you know what is the structure of wave? Please, all of you unmute yourself and tell me. Do you know? Wave.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes. Crest trough रहते, isn't it? तो दो waves radiation.
Yes.
Yes. जो radiations के waves तैयार हुए cavity के अंदर या उड़ने के अंदर, this standing wave pattern with the nodes and antinodes, maxima and minima, with the nodes at the walls of the cavity, since the electric field must vanish inside the metal, and that standing wave, if you consider in the one dimension, suppose. Then the electric field having the nodes can be given at x is equals to 0 here side mein, and length is x is equals to l. Ek dabbe ke andar wave taiyar hui yahan se wahan tak. Ek to x side uski length kya rahengi? X is equals to 0, x is equals to l. And it is given by this particular equation that energy intensity of that emitted radiation, it is given by for a one dimension E is equals to E0 sin n pi upon l into x into sin omega t. Kai ki equation hai jiye? Anybody of you please can tell me. ये काय की रिलेशन है? E is equals to E zero sine n pi upon l x into sine omega t. This is the expression for wave, mathematical expression or mathematical way of expressing the wave. Wave किसको बोलते हैं? लहर को. Wave मौज, isn't it? उतारते कैसा? In this way. Am I correct? और यही wave को लिखते कैसा? Because what is wave? Why wave? It is the dispersed one. Wave, it is the disturbance that happen in the y direction. है कि नहीं? Y direction में ऐसी करती है ना wave. इस वास्ते इसको mathematical इसको कैसे perform करते? कैसा लिखते हैं इसको? E is equals to E zero sine n pi upon l into x sine omega t. It is the mathematical way of expressing the wave that is standing wave that has been created in that particular cavity, isn't it? And here in this case, n is the positive integer and this is the pattern of standing wave, isn't it? And therefore here is the nu is the frequency of that standing wave, and nu frequency it is given by omega upon 2 pi, and therefore omega is equals to nc upon 2 pi. If you want to see the graphical representation, aisa utarte na wave, can you see the my cursor please?
Can yes
you?
Sir,
this is the first wave when n1 is equals to 1, first order. Kitne crest taiyar hue yahan pe pehle waqt? Anybody unmute and tell me by seeing the figure. देखिए आपके स्क्रीन पर वन है, फिर उसी के बाद ऐसा और थोड़ा सा ऐसा करने के बाद सेकंड वन व्हेन n इज इक्वल्स टू 2, 2 क्रिस्ट, इजंट इट 3, 4 एंड सो ऑन. दैट मींस एज n गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग, नंबर ऑफ क्रिस्ट एंड ट्रफ गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग, वेवलेंथ इज गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द स्टैंडिंग वेव पैटर्न ऑफ द इमिटेड रेडिएशन और द ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन दैट हैज बीन इमिटेड इन द ब्लैक बॉडी इन दिस कैविटी, इजंट इट. And this is nothing but this is the standing wave pattern inside the cavity. Kiska standing wave pattern hai jiye? Ye kya hai? What are these? Please unmute yourself and tell me what is this? जिसपे मेरा कर्सर है, क्या है?
वेव
है, इसकी वेव है। कहां से आई ये वेव? ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन की वेव है। ये ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन कहां जनरेट हुए, किसके अंदर? प्लीज अनम्यूट एंड टेल मी। दिस ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन आर जनरेटेड आर प्रोड्यूस इन साइड द, प्लीज अनम्यूट एंड टेल मी, किसके अंदर जनरेट हुए? ये ब्लैक कैविटी के अंदर, इजंट इट? तो वो जो रेडिएशन है वो इस तरह से चलते हैं, वेव्स की शक्ल में चलते हैं रेडिएशन, और उनकी जो है तो इस तरह से उसका ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन होगा। और मैथमेटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन कैसा होगा? E is equals to E zero sin n pi n x pi upon l into x in case of one dimension. But if suppose same as third dimension or other, if you extending the three dimension, then electric field inside this cavity due to this standing wave, it is given by E is equals to E zero sin n x pi upon l into x into sin all these things, that is x, y and z axis. Isn't it getting, please? Where n x, n y, n z is the set of positive integers. Taking the negative values of the integer, do not to give the different fields, and this amount is simply multiplying E0 by the sine factor, therefore substituting this in the electromagnetic radiation, we give. Now if you apply this one to energy, that is delta square, it is differential equation of this E is equals to dou 2 by dou x square, and this is delta E upon del square E hai, isko aisa likh sakte kya hum? Del square E, can I write like this? What is del square? Differentiation, second order derivative of this one, it is equal to this, and therefore it is 1 upon c square d2 e upon dt square, and this one we can write in this way, n square pi square or nx square pi square upon l square plus n square pi square upon l square, n z square pi square upon l square, this e is as it is, but this 1 upon c square from previous equation is omega upon c square into e, and therefore frequency nu is equal to omega upon 2 pi. If I put this value, then frequency of this emitted radiation, it is equal to c upon 2 l under root n x square. Ye solve karne ke baad n x square plus n y square plus n z square, and for the given frequency, the above equation represent the sphere of the radius in three dimension, it can be written in this way, isn't it? And this is nothing but it is this equation we have obtained, n of v is equals to 2 into 1 upon 8 4 pi r cube upon 3. If I simplify again this one, it can be written 8 pi, if we go to this side, into v, 8 3c cube into v nu cube, and this equation is nothing but, if it is again modified in this manner, then we will found that if into two modes, node and antinode, then this equation has come into existence, and this equation is nothing but it is called as the Wien's law for the black body radiation. What is Rayleigh-Jeans law? As the average energy of the mode is kT from previous we even see, it is a particular value. ये पूरा क्या है? 8 pi c square upon c, पूरा के पूरा क्या है? Constant, isn't it? And now in this way, as the average energy of the mode is kT, the radiant energy density, which is defined the average per unit volume, it can be given as u of nu dv is equals to 8 pi kT c cube nu square dv. And this equation is nothing but it is called as the Rayleigh-Jeans law. That means the black body radiations which are emitted by the black body at a particular temperature, it obeys the three important laws. One, it is the Stefan's law. Second one is the Wien's law, which is reflected by this such type of equation, that is n of v, n of nu d nu is equals to 8 pi v upon c cube into nu square into d nu, that is called as the Wien's law. And one more law is also obeyed by the black body radiations which are emitted by the black body at a particular temperature, and that law it is called as the Rayleigh-Jeans law. Now Einstein's equation, that means you may call it the quantum theory of photoelectric effect. This I have told you many times, aapko maine first year mein bhi bataya tha, second year mein bataya tha, कि आइंस्टाइन्स ने एक इक्वेशन दी 1905 में, एंड कौन सी इक्वेशन थी वो? E is equals to mc square. Now in 1905 the scientist Einstein successfully explaining the photoelectric effect and law of the photoelectric effect. क्या था photoelectric effect? कि when there is a potential difference between the two electrode, that is cathode and anode, then the electrons are positive charge or negative charge electrons are get emitted by one electrode, and they get attracted or accelerated towards the another one, and due to this motion of the electric charge from one electrode to the another electrode, the current is generated. That current it is called as the photoelectric current, and the radiations or the particles which are emitted by the anode, they are called as the photons, and this effect is called as the photoelectric effect. हम एक कंप्लीट चैप्टर ले चुके सेकंड ईयर में फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट का. डू यू रिमेम्बर दिस वन? कम से कम इतना याद है क्या फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट का चैप्टर हमारा सेकंड ईयर में हुआ? प्लीज अनम्यूट यूर सेल्फ एंड टेल मी.
जी सर.
यस, दैट मीन्स दिस इफेक्ट वॉज स्टडीड इन 1905 सक्सेसफुली बाय आइंस्टाइन. एज इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स सेक्शन आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट there are the some phenomena which are not successfully explained by the classical mechanics. So, bahut sare phenomena mein photoelectric effect bhi ek phenomena tha jisko classical mechanics satisfactorily explain nahi kar sakti thi. To kon explain kiya isko fir satisfactorily? The Shafi Bakhsh explanation kisne diya photoelectric effect ka? Please tell me, kaun si theory ne?
Einstein
theory ne, yani ke quantum mechanics ne uska jo hai to solution diya hai, isn't it? And therefore this scientist Einstein in 1905 successfully explained the photoelectric effect and law of the photoelectric effect, making the use of quantum theory of radiation, isn't it? And he assumed that, kya assume kiya usne theory mein, a light of frequency nu consists of quanta of energy or photon. Each photon has the energy h nu. Usne kya bola? कि कौन सी भी लाइट की फ्रीक्वेंसी न्यू रहती, हर एक को जो है तो कुछ एनर्जी है, दैट एनर्जी इज इन फॉर्म ऑफ क्वांटा, एंड दैट एनर्जी इज नो डाउट इन फॉर्म ऑफ क्वांटम. एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दैट एनर्जी? एच न्यू. हर क्वांटा अपने साथ कितनी एनर्जी रखता? एच न्यू. वेर एच इज व्हाट? व्हाट इज एच? प्लीज टेल. कॉन्स्टेंट, एंड न्यू इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी. And in photoelectric effect, one photon is completely absorbed by the one electron in the photo cathode. And therefore, derivation of the equation can be written in this way. Consider that there is a one photon. And if it is a one photon, it has the energy h nu. This which is get ejected from the photoelectron from of the material. And the velocity at that time is suppose u. Then we know h nu is equals to 1/2 mv² / ω. Where 1/2 mv² it is the kinetic energy of the emitted photon. Here omega is the work done or the energy spent in just bringing the electron outside the electrode. Therefore, we can say that the part of the energy incident is utilized into two parts. One part it is used in by the electron to come out of the surface. यानी जो energy photon ले रहा उसका दो हिस्सों में इस्तेमाल होता. One part it is used in bringing the electron out of the surface, and remaining is stored in form of the kinetic energy, isn't it? And suppose if the omega zero is the photoelectric wave function, that is the energy required to eject an electron out of the frequency of the light in nu, then for required purpose is given by omega zero is equal to h nu zero, and therefore this is equation number one. Suppose this frequency nu zero is known as the threshold frequency. All these threshold frequency, maximum work function, all these things we have seen in case of photoelectric effect. You are highly requested to go to the our previous chapter of the photoelectric effect in second year. If you are having any difficulty in getting this one, then the video of the photoelectric effect is also available on my YouTube channel, as I have taken it for the second year also. So all I am not repeating what is the threshold frequency, what is the work function, and all these things. Because the work function, threshold frequency, we have seen in the last period. Because in this lecture or in this particular article, we are just considering the photoelectric effect. But that photoelectric effect in light of the Einstein's theory, that means in case by in light of quantum theory, and therefore it is the frequency of light which is falling on the photosensitive surface is just able to liberate the electron without giving them any additional energy, and therefore it is clear that frequency less than nu zero will not be able to produce any photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect kab hota? Jab incident light ki energy ya frequency ek had ke upar chale jati. If the frequency of that incident radiation is below the threshold frequency, photoelectric effect does not take place. That means in order to happen the photoelectric effect, in order to orient the photoelectric effect from a metal, it is necessary that the radiation which we are falling or the radiation which are incident on the electrode should have the frequency above the a particular value, and that frequency value, it is called as the threshold frequency, as we have seen in the second year. And therefore, it is clear that if the frequency of the radiation nu zero, it will not be appear to produce the photoelectric effect, as the electron can absorb only those photons and more photons, and therefore the threshold frequency nu zero, it is given by nu zero is equals to omega zero upon h. And therefore, you can see in this case that frequency is incident on the surface. It is given by h nu is equals to 1/2 mv square max plus omega zero, and which is known as the Einstein's photoelectric equation. H nu is equals to 1/2 mv square plus omega zero. Omega zero is nothing but it is the h nu zero. If I put this h nu zero in this equation, then for h nu, can you see my cursor, please? H nu jaisa ke waisa 1/2 mv square max as it is. Instead of omega zero, what I should put, please? Please, h. Can you see my cursor?
Yes, sir.
Zero. इसमें रखे मैं क्या निकला कॉमन, आप इसको सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. 1/2 mv square maximum kinetic energy, it is given by h, common nikla, nu minus nu zero. This equation can also, but we know the relation between frequency and wavelength, that is 1 upon lambda, it is c upon lambda. Therefore, can I write this equation? Kyunki iski nu bole to kya sc upon lambda, nu zero bol kya sc upon lambda zero. Therefore, can I write this equation in this way? Yes, c, yes, so as it is c common, 1 upon lambda minus 1 upon lambda zero, where lambda and lambda zero are the wavelength corresponding to the frequency nu and nu zero. Thus, an increase in the frequency of the incident radiation is there. And with this one, I have completed this article. And in this way, for this total lecture, I have covered how many articles? We have seen Stefan's law. We have seen what? Wien's law. We have seen Rayleigh-Jeans law. And I have also threw the light on the Einstein's photoelectric equation. That means Einstein's have successfully explained the photoelectric effect by using the quantum mechanical concept. This article or this equation, that sc is equals to 1 upon lambda minus lambda zero, is most important from the examination point of view. Can you understand, please? So where lambda and lambda zero are the wavelength corresponding to the frequency nu and nu zero, and thus this is the increase in the incident frequency. And with this one, I think we should stop here today. If you are having any question, please ask me. Are you having any problem? Have you understand? Please unmute, all of you, please unmute within a minute, because 5 minutes are still there. Are you getting, please?
Yes, sir.
समझ में आया कि कोई दिक्कत आ रही? Photoelectric effect हमारा पिछले उसमें हो गया
था. समझ में
आया. We shall stop here today. Just one article, that is the one more article, Compton effect is remaining from this particular section, that I will see inshallah tomorrow at the same time. Are you ready to attend the period tomorrow at the same time, so that we can do, or we are in a position to complete this chapter? So we shall stop here.